What's the motherfucking deal, Sauce Nation? It's your boy Ed Honcho, aka at the real Ed Honcho on Instagram and Twitter. If you want to give me a follow, but if you want to catch those dripping, just tasty H-Town flavored Sauce Sports taste, you can catch me at Sauce Sports HTX on Twitter. And this is a Sauce Sports super slam dunk special situation, something. I don't know, but a bunch of S's. But we're going to talk about these Texans. You know, we talk about know your Texans. We're going down the roster in numerical order. So we're going to touch on each and every one. I'm going to drip a little bit of flavor on all of them. You know your favorite player's jersey number, so you know when to stay tuned. I know you got a couple of special ones coming up. So just jump right into it. Like I say, some of you may not know what Sauce Sports is, so let me address that. I almost forgot. Sauce Sports is a Houston Homer channel, so we talk about the Texans, the Rockets, the Astros, the Dynamo, the Dash. We're talking collegiate, professional, amateur, semi-pro, high school. You know, if it's just somebody just passing through and they did something foolish in H-Town, we're going to splash a little bit of flavor on them. But right now, we're talking about the Texans. They don't do no tomfoolery. They do the Tom Savagery, but we're not talking about Tom Savage today. We're talking about another kicker. I know y'all are like, how many damn kickers do we got? This is the last one. He's not really a kicker. He's a punter. He's a damn good old punter. Out of Texas A&M, we're talking about Mr. Shane Leckler himself, number 9, feeling fine all the time. Now, I said now he's a kicker, but I'm going to show you something a little bit different you may not have known if you listen to me speak while you're watching the highlights. We're just going to drop a little bit of flavor for y'all, of those you don't know, the Know Your Texans series. Like I said, we're going to touch on every player, but just talking about a few things, not necessarily talking about gameplay, but giving you a little bit of background. If there's anything you want to contribute to it, like I say, Sauce Nation, you are the flavor. You know what I'm saying? That makes the sauce fresh. So some extra little things you want to add on, you may want to drop into the sauce. Man, please do that in the comment section below. You know I always enjoy that. But let's get on it. First off, I don't know why he doesn't go by his first name, because his first name is Edward. He might as well be Ed Leckler. Well, what's wrong with Ed? You know, I have no complaints about Ed. But anyway, Shane Leckler came out of Texas A&M, born August 7th. 1976. That's old to me. Shit, damn. He is the third oldest player currently in the NFL at 41 years of age. Good grief. You know what I'm saying? But when you're a kicker, you can get away with stuff like that because you're not going, you know, through all those things. So about 6'2", 230, solid guy. So, you know, maybe he can lay a little hat on you. But y'all might not have known, like I say, why I'm showing this clip is he is the next in line if we lose all of our quarterbacks. You almost had to come in a game, I want to say, what was that? It was a couple of years back. It was, I think, for Savage. Savage almost got hurt, or might have got hurt that game or something. But, yeah, Shane was going to come in, but this wasn't him, you know, actually warming up. But he is next in line if that happens to come into play. So, anyway, just a little nugget. He's played 238 consecutive games, which I think is the current leader in the NFL right now for consecutive games played. Like I said, we're not going to knock him for being a kicker. We're going to show him love. We're going to let him drip his sauce because he's a Texan. We ain't going to hate. He's a 9-time All-Pro, 5-time leader in punting average in the NFL. So what I'm saying is, dude is a damn good punter, not just your running the mill. He's getting up there, but he's still a solid fucking punter. So, you know what I'm saying? Even though he's a little bit older, he's still got some leg to him. You know, guys like that, like I said, they don't take as much of a beating, as much damage. As long as that leg keeps going, you know, they'll be able to go. You know, it was like Vinatieri and a couple other guys. The other two guys that are older, both kickers, as a matter of fact. So, you know, kicking is a different thing. Like I say, he was a 7-time Pro Bowler. We just extended him a year in March. So, yeah, I'm looking at my notes. So, you know, you hating on me, I don't give a damn. I got to check my notes, make sure. But he was drafted originally in 2000, okay? So there's some of you guys, some of you members, some of you ingredients in the sauce, a.k.a. Sauce Nation members. Y'all weren't even born in 2000. Some of y'all are young and some of y'all are some juvies. But it's okay. You know what I'm saying? He's had a longer NFL career than you've been alive. But don't, it's all right. You know, that's not your fault. You know what I'm saying? That's a good thing for him. You know, a lot of people wish they could say that. But that's actually an amazing thing. Because, I mean, there's a lot of kickers that come through the league and still don't last that long. So you have to be a damn good kicker to last that long in the league. So he's out of East Bernard, Texas. I have no idea where that is. No, I did not look it up. So, and I'm not going to look it up. So if you know where East Bernard, Texas is, you know, drop that in the comments below. Maybe y'all can you can school me on a little bit of something, you know, put a little bit of sauce on the video for me, because I have no idea where East Bernard, Texas is. It's somewhere in Texas, apparently, but that's all I can tell you. Came to Texas in 2013, so he's been with us a little bit before the BOB regime, but definitely a piece that needed to stay, because like I say, he's been a good, consistent guy. Like I say, it's just with the kickers and the special teamers, sometimes it's hard to put a little bit of flavor on. You know, you appreciate what they're doing when they're good at what they do. There's no complaints. You know, you just say, hey, stay consistent. That's all we can ask from you. That's all we can hope for. That's all we can want. So, You know, I have no complaints, like I say, with the extension. They have some young guys, like I said, we talked about the first video in the series, Corey Carter out of TSU. And like I say, he looks to be a good guy. They may be bringing him along. They signed him, like I said, when they signed him to that futures contract to eventually be a replacement in case of, you know, he may, Selectler may want to say, hey, you may want to call the rep. He may want to move on. But for now, he's still a Texan, and, you know, we love that, so ain't nobody hating on that. A little bit of self-promotion, you know, got to do it every video. Go get fresh, go get fly, go get you a Soft Sports shirt, go get your grandma's Soft Sports shirt, go get your uncle a Soft Sports shirt. You know, I'm telling you, just go get everybody. Go buy one for your whole neighborhood. It's going to be the hottest back-to-school item and all that good shit, man. Just go get you some sauce, go get your flavors. A few of those left, like I said, we're limited to 25, and then, you know, say we're gonna do something different. Like I said, I got some other things in the works, so, you know, continue to be creative. Now, you know, we have to keep it stale. We got to keep the sauce fresh. But if you ain't got one, go to sauceports.com and get you one. You know what I'm saying? And multiple colors, not just black. We got the blue, we got the red, we got the orange, you know, representative of the H-Town colors. So with that being said, if you like what I'm talking about, first and foremost, you gotta show some love. You gotta be an ingredient. If you like shit, you gotta say something. You know what I'm saying? That's what being a member of Sauce Nation is. That's what being an ingredient is in the sauce. You gotta comment. You gotta show some love. You gotta speak your piece. You gotta put your opinion. You know, like, tell me what you think about Shane Lechler. Edward Shane Lechler. We need to call him Ed Lechler. But you know, as you see, he got a little bit of gun in the highlights. But you know, tell me how you feel about him. I mean, I don't really think there's too much more we could ask for from a punter than what we're getting out of him. But like I say, with him getting up there in age, you know, we may have to start looking to the future. But for the foreseeable future, I think he's a solid piece, and that's nothing to worry about. But let me know how you guys think. I'm not going to sway your opinion. How do you feel? Do you think the young guy may be coming up? Do you think something different? I don't know. But like I say, but if you like what we're talking about, subscribe to the channel, because you're always going to be dropping sauce. Always going to be putting some flavor on something, whether you like it or not. If you're not an H-Town fan, you might not want to. You know, might not want to get in the sauce because the flavor might be too much for you. Might be overwhelming. You might not have the taste buds. This is an acquired taste. You may not have that. You might be ready for the sauce. But with that said, man, I'm going to stop rocking with y'all. Out. It's your boy, Ed Honcho. Do some Sauce Nation. Y'all be cool like y'all be cool. Stay tuned, because this was jersey number 9. So you know who in the win. Jersey number 10, you got to stay tuned for that, because that's going to be coming to you live and direct, because I know y'all want to hear me splash some sauce on that one, because it's my favorite player on the office. Y'all already know who it is. I ain't even going to say his name, because y'all already know who it is. Stay tuned. Deuce.